Hello?
Rabbi Aaron, you didn't fall asleep, did you?
No, don't be silly. What's up?
We need you at the shul right away. Something weird is happening.
I'll be right over. Debbie, what are you doing here?
What am I doing here? I'm protecting our lovely synagogue, of course.
You're not a security guard?
I'm not. I've been here for 10 years. What are you talking about?
Is Rabbi Kornberg okay with this?
Rabbi Kornberg? I haven't given that guy a second thought since we were in preschool together and he messed up the Megillah reading.
I thought he was your husband.
So weird.
See ya.
Kornberg, are you ready for Purim? It's your favorite holiday, man!
No, I hate Purim.
What do you mean? It's Purim! It's your favorite holiday!
No, silly Megillah reading.
Purim's your favorite holiday!
No.
You know, I just saw Debbie. Is she okay?
Debbie who?
Rabbi Aaron, can I talk to you?
Sure.
Rabbi Aaron, you know it's not a good idea to talk to Rabbi Kornberg about Purim.
Really?
Don't you remember what happened all those years ago?
What?
Baruch Hashem! Rabbi Aaron, we need to talk! In your office, now, quick!
Oh my God.
Adina, come!
What's up?
We have a major problem.
I know! What's with Debbie Kornberg being a security guard and Rabbi Kornberg not liking Purim?
I know! The whole space-time continuum has been disrupted.
Space-time continuum?
Well, we've never told you this, but we have a time machine here at Beth-Om.
Really? Cool.
Not cool. You see, our sixth graders went back in time to learn the story of Purim, but Haman snuck in, stole the time machine, and went back to the time when Rabbi Kornberg and Debbie were in preschool together.
Why would he go back there?
Because that is when Rabbi Kornberg read from the Megillah for the first time. He fell in love with Purim, Debbie fell in love with him, and the two of them decided that Beth-Om would always have the best Megillah reading and the best Purim carnival ever.
You mean the one that's taking place on March 16th between 11 a.m. and 2 p.m.?
Exactly.
The one.
So let me get this straight.
By going back in time and taking the Megillah at that precise moment, Haman is stopping Beth-Om from having the best Purim ever?
Exactly.
Rabbi Ernst, you need to go back in time and make sure that Rabbi Kornberg reads from that Megillah.
Hurry! Alana's waiting for you by the time machine!
Okay. This is a time machine. You have to be very, very careful about it, Rabbi Aaron.
It's very, very expensive, and it took us, three Torah projects to pay for it? You have to be very careful with it.
You got it, Alana. Mm-hmm. Hey, how does it work?
Oh, well, you have to get it to 28 miles an hour.
28? Shouldn't it be 88?
Rabbi Aaron, this is a catering truck. It's not a DeLorean. Today,
hello.
We are going to do our Megillah readings, and I hope you're all prepared. Who would like to go first?
Me.
Rabbi Kornberg, are you ready?
What's this, Debbie? Yeah.
Come on up. Come on up.
Rabbi Kornberg, your Megillah reading is in danger.
What? Who are you?
We go back a long ways. Anyways, a really bad man is going to come in here and try to take the Megillah away from you, and the entire Purim depends on it. Oh no, it's Haman! Rabbi Kornberg, you must stop him!
Boo! Boo! Boo!
Who's gonna stop me? You? These kids? That Megillah is mine! I will restore my good name and ruin Purim for all of Bethlehem from here until eternity! Now give me that Megillah!
No! No, Haman! Leave it alone!
No, that is mine!
Where's the Megillah?
At Bethlehem, we hope to see you at our Purim events.
Happy Purim!